talking while you come around and now they silent. Through the Cooper 17, no guidance. You be staying low, but you know what the price is. Ain't never got you, know it, being modest. Popping, shipping only cause you know you popping, yeah.
It's your boy Trunks, back at it again. We're in the video, kid. Ooh. Mr. Pickle. Money. Ooh, 20 people. I got that money. Yang. Money. Hey, it's your boy Trunks. Back at it again with another video. Hey, we knew it. Are you doing another? What if, bro? Whoa. Ha. I'm joking. But what's up, guys? It's your boy Cody. In the background, I'm playing a DBZ Kakarot. Ooh, yeah, because, like, the game kind of started me over on the progress I had. So, like, I was at the Cell Saga. Like, at the Gohan versus, Cell fight. And then, like, I just ran into the game so I could get some heals. Because, you know, it doesn't let you leave. And then, I was like, wah. And yeah. Bro, Vegeta is litty. That's why I like making what ifs about him, kind of. Oh, you get wrecked. They get wrecked. Cybermen get wrecked. Yamcha, do something. Come on. Yeet. Because I helped you all that much. But if I get a little sidetracked doing this part, well, it is kind of the final part. So, like, I'm trying to get this what if out the way so I can just, like, worry about what if Naruto has stage mode. Bro, part two is kind of awesome. Part three will be, I will try to make it come out as soon as I can, because I like really kind of, I really want like part two to come out, so like, I mean part three, but like, I'm gonna make all the parts today and just rewatch them over and over again and wait and make y'all wait and for the up when it uploads. Cause I wanna be like that. Yeah. Cause it is kind of my second favorite what if. So, let's get into this one. So, We're in the Tournament of Power. Tournament of Power. Alright, so. We're about to go to Nappa's perspective. A recap on last part. Basically, Universe 4 and 2 were taken out. Universe 2 is the first universe to get taken out. Because of Bardock. Bardock went on a rampage. Took two of them out. And Goku took Red Brienne out. We saw an appearance from Goku Black. Revealing Zamasu. And like talking about Zamasu. And their secret weapon. Vegeta. Vegeta? Wait, Vegeta? Like Vegeta. First. I'm gonna go ahead and pause this, so let's get right into this! Trunks is finally woken up. No, Goku's finally woken up. I didn't defeat Goku Black. And Goku hits Trunks in the back of the head. Shut up, Trunks. You did defeat him. Look up there. And he points at Goku Black. Wait. What? I did defeat him? Wait, Goku. What are you doing? I'm about to go fight Jared. Get my revenge. No. No. Goku puts his response back on saying, "It's fine, Trunks. Bro, you can come with if you want. He's pretty strong. I think I'm the only one that could defeat him." What do you mean, Goku?
Not even you. Not even your entire family. The team in this tournament right now could defeat. I bet even plus Gine and Goten, y'all still wouldn't be able to. Shut up, Trunks. Shut up doubting me. I can do whatever I want. Goku, it's a dumb move. You wanna know something else is dumb? The fact that you thought you could take on Goku Black alone without any help. But Goku, you're the one that listened to me. I only listened to you so I could go fight Jiren. I didn't want you getting in my way. Goku! And then Trunks takes out his sword and points it right at Goku. Don't you dare. Goku grabs Trunks' sword and throws it away. It's practically on the edge. Trunks, don't play with me. Goku walks off pretty slow. That Goku, he's stupid. And Trunks picks up his sword and walks the other way. Goku sees Jiren once again. Alright, Jiren. Now we can have a one-on-one battle. Son Goku. You think you can defeat me alone? Yeah. I just got a little bit held back. Because of my fear. I didn't want them to get hurt in the process. Do whatever you can. Whoa! Powering up to his full power. No, let's say he only powers up to Super. No, he powers up to Super Saiyan Blue Ultimate. Ultimate Blue. Goku powers up. And he's just charging. Not even you, Jiren, could say, I'm weak. My powers is way stronger. Then watch your deck. Goku's eyes turn green. He makes two ki blasts in his hands, destroying them. Wait, they weren't even ki blasts. They were spirit bombs. You think you could defeat me? He charges a tree. Jiren! He makes another spirit bomb. He puts his hand in the air, makes a spirit bomb. This is the full power of a spirit bomb! Spirit bomb! Jiren caught Goku's hand before it could even reach him. Goku, you think you're that strong? He charges another punch in his other hand and punches Goku in the stomach. You're weaker than before, even with that spirit bomb stuff. Goku jumps on a mountain. Fine then, I'll just go full power. He puts both of his hands in the air. Full power spirit bomb. Everyone in this universe puts their hands in the air. Hands in the air like you just don't care. Universal Spirit Bomb! Why don't you get it, Jiren? Jiren. Jiren catches it with his eyesight. Goku, you're pathetic! Jiren! And he powers up to Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Ultimate Blue Kaioken. You think you can beat me? Dad! Gohan and Gohan jump up to the pool. They power up to Super Saiyan Blue using a Kamehameha to support it. But Goku trips them, saying, this is my battle. Please, Gohan. fight your own. Please!
Pushing his spirit bomb at Jiren in full power. And then yelling, go.
Times 25! Dad! No! Dad. You don't think this is just one? Come on, Gohan. I know I can do it. Leave it to me. Dad. Leave it to me!
Pushing the spirit bomb.
It looks like his... And then the spirit bomb starts coming back at him. Go on.
And then Goku stops. And he's about to fall on the spirit bomb. And while he's falling, Gohan jumps in.
Dad! Don't! Go!
Gohan. I'm done for. Falling into the spirit bomb.
Dad!
Then Gohan jumps in too, right after. All three of them fall into the spirit bomb. But two people emerge, getting pushed out by Goku. Gohan and Gohan come back out. Full with rage, they start charging to their maximum power.
Jiren, you did this!
And they're just charging until their father emerges. And he looks at Jiren. Jiren's powers are I think he was like, he would be a 5% and he would go to 7%. That might even be over.
Or
revealing himself in his old gi.
Jiren.
Charging at Jiren full power. Making a spirit bomb in his hand.
Jiren!
He's fighting Jiren. Now remember in this timeline, he is stronger. So Jiren powers up to probably the same power he was at fighting. Let's say... Alright, we'll go for... How about half power? To take this threat on, and then he punches Goku in the face. I guess the fight would go the same as it did in canon. But as the only thing different is that he would be at half power and Goku would get blasted away. Now Gohan and Gohan would retreat going after Goku. Now when Goku wakes up, someone emerges from the darkness.
Vegeta!
But he's in a black suit, and it's not what he was wearing. He was wearing his battle armor.
Vegeta, I'm Vegeta Black.
Vegeta, what are you...
And Goku, don't play with an immortal.
Vegeta! This isn't like you. You don't...
Is that Vegeta?
No. He's from the other team. Vegeta's from Universe 7, like Goku.
I'm sorry for doing the bad Zeno voice.
Well... Looks like he's beating up Goku right now. Goku's still tired from that battle, so... Not surprising. Poor Goku. I think his universe is gonna lose to that dude. And he just said he's immortal?
So does that mean if we do destroy his universe, he's still gonna be alive? I don't think so. Could though. So, should we do it? No, that's what the universe, this tournament's all about. I guess you're right. Let's just see this outcome.
Vegeta, what are you doing? Beating you up, Kakarot. What's wrong with that? Vegeta!
Goku goes flying.
You know I'm weakened.
Vegeta Black.
Zamasu!
Goku can barely even charge up a Kamehameha, but he pulls it off.
Kamehameha!
No point in that. Vegeta Black just hits it away. I'm stronger than that, Goku Black.
I'm Vegeta Black! I came to finish you off, Goku!
Goku is losing his vision.
Vegeta.
He saves himself, though. He punches Vegeta just at the right time before falling to the ground. Goku clenches his fist.
Vegeta! Don't do this!
Goku takes off his Zeno clothing, revealing his old gi. And then Ultra Instinct turns on.
Ha!
Goku is barely able to walk.
My body hurts so much!
But then he's barely even able to throw a punch. But this punch is so powerful. It sends he punches Vegeta Black in the face. It's like basically what he does to Vegeta in Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. When he's like, punt, and then like, it's like after a beam struggle when he just like charges a Vegeta. And he just holds his punch in Vegeta's face, and then it sends him flying. No, this sends him flying out the ring. So Vegeta Black's eliminated, and Zamasu reveals himself, which makes Goku jump towards him, kicking him in the stomach, sending him flying out the ring. Before that, Goku Black was it. Like, before Goku Black was even taken out, most of them were already gone. They were the only three left, so their universe is deleted. Now Goku falls to the ground in even more pain, rolling around. At this point, he's barely able to move. He has the same type of pain that he did when he was taken out of Ultra Instinct. So his sons run up to him, saying, why would he even break his limits like that? Goku puts on his outfit back on and says, he didn't. It just happened.
Dad, you're gonna need to calm down.
No. They both give him equal amount of energy. And now Goku can walk. He's still in a little bit of pain, but yeah. So, Goku is just walking around the stage, asking himself, why would this ever happen? If I wasn't such an idiot, this would have never happened.
Why do I have to be so dumb?
Goku ran into Kale and Caulifla.
Now, he gets all of the Saiyans to do a, like the, whatchamacallit, the, to do the ritual so Caulifla can become a Super Saiyan. God. And it happens. Now Goku tells her to run along. He can't fight right now. Whenever he gets enough key, he will be able to. But Caulifla does not understand this. Kale becomes berserk and basically the fight goes normal. Like Caulifla and Kale is Goku. Goku goes to God. Boom, yada yada this, yada yada that. Goku goes Ultra Instinct, but instead he goes Mr. Ultra Instinct. Now we're finally getting into Vegeta's perspective. So Vegeta's just walking around, kicking out people while he walks. Little baby Kiba. And then he runs into this wannabe Frieza. Hey. Do you want to get killed or something? If I were you, I would run off. Or I would treat you like how I treated Frieza.
Vegeta, you don't have to be so evil.
Not evil. And before he even knows it, Vegeta's right in front of him and he punches him in the air. Get on somewhere. Or, well, see you later.
What? You buffoon!
And then he starts launching a barrage of key blasts. With Vegeta he does the footwork that Goro does on episode 10. Like, at the end of it. Like, he's just like, yeet, yeet, yeet. From the arrows, because he knows they're poisonous. And then after doing all that footwork, he sees death beams. Death beams? And death beams are coming at him, and he's dodging out the way more and more. This Frieza bastard. What is he doing? And then he puts his hands in the air, still doing his footwork, saying, "Final! Flash!" Destroying all the death beams coming towards him. And taking Frost. Well, it doesn't take Frost down. Frost is falling down. And Vegeta transforms into Super Saiyan.
Royal Saiyan Punch!
This is a new move that he developed while training. And then punching Frost in the side. Like, they're close to the edge. Like, and he sends them the opposite way from the edge. And Frost goes flying out the edge still. Since there's no Mr. Risha, there's no seal away. No boy seal away. Now, Universe 6 has been deleted. I know I'm just deleting universes at this point because I want to get past this, but you know, that's not really it. It's because, like, there's no point in, like, showing the fights if they, Universe 7, since they've had more training, they take care of it, like, lightweight. So, yeah, there's really no point in showing it. So now it's only down to Universe 7 and 11, which I think is the universe. So everyone meets up. Now the entire Universe 7 hasn't been eliminated yet. But there's three left in Universe 11. Everyone's confident that they will win. So dang, you should get ready to fight.
No. No, Goku, I mean, Goku, Bardock, and Vegeta, walk up to Jiren. Jiren, we're gonna defeat you! Charging up to Super Saiyan. Jiren charges before they're even finished punching Vegeta, taking him out of commission. But then Vegeta pulls through. Ah! Jiren! Punching him in the face. Then he turns blue, but his hair's more spiky. Now that Vegeta's in what I call Super Saiyan Royal. Bro, you got, like, Super Saiyan Blue Evolution? No. Super Saiyan Royal. Super Saiyan Blue Royal. I mean, Super Saiyan Royal. Because Royal is, isn't it like a type of blue color? Or, like, at least call it Blue Royal. Because, like, I love that name. Now with all of them in their full power. Goku powering up to Kaioken Ultimate. They charge at Jiren. Jiren! Hame! Guys, just hold him off! Hame! Ha! 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 Saiyan! Saiyan! Fist! Saiyan! Dragon! Fist! Now there! Now Vegeta, you do the behind work. No, I'm not doing that, fool. Prince Barrage! He learned this along with Prince Fist in the fist move that he learned earlier. And then, last but certainly not least, Vines! Saiyan! Guidance! Dragon! Fist! Barrage! With so many hits coming at him, Jiren can barely catch him. But he's just barely getting there on time. Because their coordinating is so off, is so good. Like, it's like they've been training for their entire lives. Vegeta's barely getting along with this play, saying he's not fine with being like this. He's not fine with letting this dude play with them. So he starts speeding up, so he's on par with Kakarot. When he's supposed to be like, he's not even supposed to be on par with Kakarot. He's supposed to be a little bit slower. So this causes Bardock to speed up to like power, and then he starts speeding up to Kakarot's level. So Jiren's not taking this lightly. So then he kicks, and then he jumps in the air, launching a blast at them. With the team pulling through, flying towards it, pulling their fists back, yelling, "Jiren, Jiren, I will kick your head off." Kids, you already know I can't say that word. Jiren! Goku pulls out his power pole, yelling at Jiren. Jiren! Then he starts speeding up on his own. While they're charging at him, he did the strongest. And now he's pushing through. He's pushing through everything with the power pole that's pushing him up. Grabbing the other two's hands while pushing him up with the power pole. And then he lets go. Jiren, and Goku start having, I guess, kind of like a sword fight. But like, Jiren's just catching it. And then, like, yeah. It's until Goku gets hit. Jiren finds out his way. So Goku is about to hit Jiren. Extend power pole! And then Jiren catches the power pole, taking it out of Goku's hand. Then hitting Goku, sending him flying down into the rocks. And then since he has the power pole, he's just like, whatever. And then he hits all of them, sending them flying back, throwing the power pole at them. And the power pole is coming down, hitting Goku in the stomach. Not putting him out of commission, but kind of putting him in a lot of pain. He grabs onto the power pole. Jiren! Now Jiren's falling down, because remember, he can't fly. You can't fly in this tournament. So then he tells the power pole to extend. Extend! Power pole! Hitting Jiren in the stomach, sending him flying. Goku swinging around the power pole in the air. And then he basically does. And then he brings Jiren to the other side, hitting him on the ground. Jiren! And then the next thing he knows, Goku has two fingers, is right on top of him. And he starts hitting him with a barrage. Move out of here! Cutting Jiren. Well, not cutting him, because Power Pole can't really cut things. Then he throws the power pole at Bardock. And then he's now on top of Jiren, saying, Kamehameha! Then getting the power pole back. And then Jiren, before he even knows it, Goku hits him in the head. He starts talking himself. Let me give you a little bit of sense. Then Jiren finally catches it, saying, you think all this friendship stuff gets you through this tournament? He uses the power pole and then teleports in front of one of his teammates. His teammate being Nappa. Before Nappa really even has time to show his play, Jiren hits him out. Home run! His God of Destruction says. And before anyone else knows it, he's aiming for Broly. Broly catches this and throws the power pole up, grabs the power pole, throwing Jiren away. And then teleporting to Goku, giving him the power pole. Goku, now filled with rage, holds onto the power pole. He makes a spirit bomb, throwing it in the air, swinging his power pole and hitting it. He sends the spirit bomb flying with Jiren in the air because he's jumping. And then it hits Jiren in the stomach. Jiren says, friendship won't save you. Making a giant ki blast, throwing it at him. Goku uses the power pole to hit it away. And he starts doing a barrage of ki blasts. Goku's just hitting it away. Just keep it. Until his speed is unmatched. Hitting Jiren's ki blast away. Until he says, Jiren! Making the spirit bomb out of the sword. Stop playing with me! Throwing the spirit bomb from out of the sword. Goku falls on the ground. Then telling the power pole to extend. Extending towards Jiren. Goku is using this as a diversion to stop Jiren. Or at least keeping him in the air. And then he hits Jiren. It hits Jiren. And then Jiren sees Goku.
Goku! Extend Power Ball! Super Long Extension Power Ball!
But before he's even able to hit you, the Power Pole falls out his hand.
What?
Bardock was holding on to it.
And he's behind him, saying,
"Thanks, Goku!"
And Goku knows his strategy and says,
"Saiyan Dragon Fast!"
And he turns right in the stomach, zooming past. Then Bardock tells him,
"Get on somewhere!"
Hitting Jiren. This doesn't send Jiren very far. It doesn't even get him close to going out of the ring. But the reason why Vegeta wasn't there is because he left to go fight Toba. Because he's made himself a god of destruction.
And then they see Gohan
going up to his dad.
Dad! Taking out his sword that he used to have while he was a kid.
Throwing it at him.
Goku catches it, saying,
"Dual wielding!"
With both of his swords, the two weapons, jumping at Jiren, saying,
"Dragon Saiyan Ball! Saw!"
Combining the power of them together, putting the Power Pole's power inside of Gohan's sword, saying,
"Extend! Sword!"
Then he cuts Jiren. But Jiren blocks it with a key blast. He cut his hand a little bit. Then Jiren uses his key blast and throws it at Goku, hitting Goku. But he didn't hit Goku. Goku blocked it with the sword, y'all.
Time for full power! Sword work!
Jiren caught the sword, breaking the extended part. Unfusing the swords, the sword fell out of Goku's hand, but Goku has the power pull still.
Extend power pull!
Gohan powered his way up with his with Ki Blast. No, with a Kamehameha. Now that all three of them are up there, they do it. Ida, Todoroki. Well, no. Let's not do this. Goku charges a punch. Since Gohan's coming up, he charges a kick. And then from up top, Bardock charges up a move, yelling, "This is a new move he learned.
Saiyan Blast!"
Throwing it at Jiren. And they all hit him. But Jiren protected himself, grabbing Goku's hand and Gohan's leg, throwing him back down. And then with the top of him so protected, he throws himself up, catching Bardock. While he's falling down, he hits Bardock on the ground. Then putting Bardock out of commission, and he tells Bardock, "You put up a good fight, but you're just not strong enough to defeat me." Keep blasting him out of the ring.
Dad! Jiren!
Now Gohan and Goku are fighting with their sword/pole. No one really cares anymore, okay? He doesn't use Power Pole. And they're just hitting him. Barely even touching him. They charge up a move, yelling out,
"God, Son, Father, Power!"
Falling on the ground, saying, "Fake." Goku uses his Power Pole to hit Jiren in the face, with Gohan coming back up with sword work. Jiren catches both of them, hitting them on the ground.
I guess we should get to a different fight, because we just know they're getting wrecked right now. These three are teaming up. Dispo. Teaming up. Oh, Dispo. Yeah. Now, Broly not getting any shine time. Makes him kind of disappointed. So he tries to get as much shine time as he can to impress Lord Beerus. Because Lord Beerus has been given, like, all these other Saiyan's names, but not him. No, they don't. Beerus, when I see Nappa, they're like, it's all good, Nappa. Just don't be a retard like that ever again. But Lord Beerus, I only got knocked out because that Jiren fell out. I was fighting Dispo. Then that cat bunny dude. And then that dude just popped out of nowhere and hit me with the power pole. He wasn't really far away. And I don't know the power pole stuff. That I don't train with Goku. Fine. At least you gave me a good excuse, Nappa. Sorry, Lord Beerus. Oh my god, Genos is being OP! Sorry. So, Nappa finds a way out of that situation. Booty. Trunks comes up behind while but right behind him, he didn't notice this. Trunks is about to chop him, but he uses his speed to run behind Trunks, kicking him in the back. You and that big dude are working together to kill me. I don't really it was a black dude's voice, so like I can basically use my own. You two were trying to kill me. You two were trying to double team. Justice kick! Justice rush! Justice ball!
Charges towards Dispo, yawning out his new moon. Big bang! This has to work. Bomb! Twisting like how Bakugo does in the anime against Todoroki, putting one of his hands out, with explosions coming from his new moon. Hitting Dispo. I wasn't expecting that from this dude. Then kicking him in the face, sending him flying. Right behind him was Trunks. Alright. Big bang! Attack! Then Broly uses. Charges up in the move. God flame. destruction. God flame destruction? Funny girl. This bow running right through it. Now. Wanna know what I like? The power to look you in the face. And not wanna beat you to a bloody pulp. What did you say? And then. He's flashing in and out. In and out. He can't see him. What's happening to... Broly's right in his face and punches him straight off the ring. Pathetic. The weakness you show. Everything you lack. Charlotte tells her. I'm sorry. Him before he falls off out the ring. So I guess we're free then, right? Free? Is that what you say? Sure, if that's what you want to say. I don't think free is even the right word. I would say. We still have lots more to do. But this one didn't fall off. Do you think you're not going without a fight? Because he's just holding on. He grabs Broly's leg and he grabs Trunks' leg, saying, come with me! Kicking in the wind. Taking Broly and Trunks with him. Broly! With the team falling out. Now, since he's the god of destruction, he's ready to take out anyone.
Oh, I'm really proud of you! And you're incredible too, Tree! You kept her safe this entire time! Like you held on to her! Thank you!
Sorry. Now then. I don't know where Vegeta pops in, punching Topo in the face, sending him flying.
Then he starts throwing Hakai's at him. Yeah.
Blasting. And then before she knows it, Vegeta's right in front of her, kicking him. Sprint! Barrage! He's kicking, he's punching, and then he kicks him in the... He does what Gogeta does when he kicks him, and then he flies back. Final! Go! Final Prince Flash! Hit him now! Turtles is already on. He stands up right in front of him, punching him.
I swear on my life.
He's out!
Don't know how, but I'll find
he
you.
Might be a
okay.
Prince, but he's a horrible.
Follow the river downstream.
King! And then he charges a move, kicking, basically what they do in DBZ Kakarot.
Well, look who's finally awake. Good morning, Big Oaf.
You're alive too! They're hot people, you're butt naked! Hands off! I'm not joking!
It's October 5th.
Gohan jumped. He jumped into the air. Kyle! Pushing him up. And then he teleports. He touches Topo.
Like, it
has been 37
years. And right when Vegeta is about to punch him in the face, he teleports. So all three of them are in the air. Vegeta, since you...
4, 5, 6, 7
Use final... Don't leave me out.
1, 2, 3, 4,
Blue. 5. Flying blast.
So that whole time you were
processing.
New move.
You just already know this.
I woke myself awake before then. Being out here stark naked with no supplies in winter would have meant game over pretty damn quickly. I realized I would have to start things up in the springtime. So keeping an extremely precise account of the time was an absolute must. Alright, we're here. We need to put a pin in the small talk and get to work.
Senku, you're telling me you did this on your own?
Took him out? No. No, Vegeta, after this, he teleports, he moves towards him, and went up. No! Super God Prince! Punching Topo in the face, turning a different way, sending him flying out the ring. What type of move was that? I used my god key. And I put it all in my hand. So that's why you do. So that's what you did. So what you did is. You took out all of your.
Anita Verosa, toxic. But if she may G safe. Anita Muscaria, toxic. If something looks like it's out of a Mario game, pass it up. Next, Mugwort, that's edible. Wolfsbane, are you trying to poison us?
Punching him far away, sending him flying. So basically, what he did is he put all of his God Key power, so he transformed back into base. And since he's in that form, it's stronger, and he puts it in his fist and hits him away. Kitty.
He couldn't fight it either.
So, now it takes Topo out. So, but Topo isn't really done for. No, he actually is.
That's a top priority. I mean, the two of us alone, just a couple of dudes. Can't restart humanity if you catch my drift.
Yeah, that's true.
Besides, why after 3,700 years did we break free from our petrified condition?
The stone rotted away?
Well, something like that. Say the strange mineral hadn't been corroded. Can you chalk up the timing to mere random coincidence?
So
6 months apart is
now they're all teaming up to beat Jiren's big, big meme. So I'm, according to my calculations, there shouldn't be four left because, Broly, Turtles, Gohan, Bardock, who else was it? Well, I guess you can count Nappa, and so that would be six, and who else, bro? Raditz. Oh, Raditz was never eliminated. Oh, so Raditz wasn't in this tournament, so like, it was actually Trunks. I couldn't remember Trunks, okay. No, Trunks. Trunks is all Gucci and Gucci flames. I might just roast you because you're my. Bruh. So Goku powers down to just Super Saiyan Blue, having confidence in his team charging, taking out his heart. Jiren, take this. Now Shao charges, but then Jiren punches Shao. Since they're basically at the edge of the ring, he throws them off the ring. So there's Shao got out. I guess there's a three left. Gohan takes the far range attacks, while Goku and Vegeta take on the close range. Now I guess it would go the same as it did in canon. With like Frieza and yeah.
Now that you guys have me on your side, you won't have to just dream about filling your bellies.
No, he would kick out Gohan. Taking out Gohan. No, he doesn't take out Gohan. Gohan's like on his little piece of rock. And then he takes out Vegeta, landing on this piece of rock too. No! And then he starts getting beat up. Too really bad. Then he gets beat up. But he transforms. And then he goes Ultra Mastered Ultra Instinct.